We're back with another one. You know how it's going down, man. The antidote, the hottest shit going in the city. You know, we trend-setting shit. Real Proper TV. Live with Swayze, live from Images Apparel Bar. 341 Plank Road, Suite B. You know, I got the star, Marcel P. Black in this bitch.
What's up, bitch?
Good? What's poppin', my nigga?
Cooler, man. Just trying to maintain, bro. Beautiful Saturdays, chilling out, bro.
Yeah, shit, Jay. What's been poppin' with you, man?
Oh, man, bro. Just, back to work, bro. Had a nice little run this summer doing a little tour. You know what I'm saying? I hit Tennessee, Oklahoma, Dallas, Texas. Did some shows in Alabama. You know what I'm saying? Right. Of course, New Orleans. And, you know, Baton Rouge, what have you. Just moving, man.
How you got connected? Was your own tour? You was on
my own tour? Yeah, bro. I'm one man army. I ain't got no manager, no team. Just myself, bro. I do everything myself. Been doing it for a long time. Man, just working this independent angle, bro. You know what I'm saying? It all started. You know, I started doing shows in Baton Rouge.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So, well, I take that back. So I started doing shows in New Orleans first, because when I really first started getting out here serious, it wasn't a whole lot going on.
Right.
But so I started doing a whole lot of shows in New Orleans. I met a lot of people out there. My OG out there, Truth Universal, you know, pretty much the OG of the whole South Louisiana in terms of like the underground hip hop scene. He co-signed me to a whole lot of places. So through him, I met a cat in Texas. Through him, I met a cat in Mississippi who put me on some guys from Tennessee and, you know, vice versa, just like that. So what I started doing was, okay, I started bringing all these places that I would go to, you know what I'm saying, I would bring them to Baton Rouge. They'd bring me to their spot. When they bring me to their spot, I meet somebody else. You know what I'm saying? I bring somebody from St. Louis, I go to St. Louis. You know what I'm saying? And so, it just been a blessing, man. Just building up, meeting connections, meeting new people, you know, on the kind of like the underground hip hop side of things. Been blessed to have my profile raised enough to where I don't necessarily have to depend on show swaps or what have you. People just call me, you know what I'm saying? Or, you know, thank God I got a good name. I can say, I see somebody doing some things. Send my website, send my press kit, text them such and such, yo, I'm Truth Universal boy, I run with Kamikaze out of Jackson. You know, they co-sign go a long way. You know what I'm saying? So go out there, make sure you know what I'm saying, bust my ass, perform, do a good set, be professional, bring my value up, you know what I'm saying, to where they call me back, what have you. So bro, it's been a long time coming, bro. I worked very, very hard at it for maybe like 2 or 3 years, and like it really started coming into fruition probably like late 2012. Then 2013 was a great year for me, but it's just been a long time grinding, hard working, bro.
Yeah, you got a mixtape out?
Nah, bro. I got six EPs, two albums. I just recently dropped a single called People First. You know, produced by my man Fifth Child out of Jackson, or what have you. You know, it's a SoundCloud. It's kind of dealing with what's going on in African America in terms of like. Police brutality, things of that nature. So it wasn't really nothing I was really trying to profit off of. Or,
right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, just something for the time.
Just something for the time,
get,
man. Something because like
people through.
You know, man. It's like so many times, bro. It's like, especially with Baton Rouge. I'm just keep out 100 with you, dog. Right. All this stuff is going on, man. Anybody really talking about what's going on, like outside of the trap shit, outside of the fantasy world, and the hip hop in general.
The hidden.
It's not necessarily hidden because it's going on. Like, shit, where we at right now, you know what I'm saying? Niggas is hurting, niggas are starving, you know what I'm saying? Niggas is facing systematic racism and oppression and things of that nature. But it's just not the stuff that people think is gonna sell. Or people that think it's gonna get them popular or whatever. So somebody gotta speak up, you know what I'm saying? You know, speak out against the oppression that's taking place. And somebody gotta speak up for the people that's oppressed or whatever. So with this particular song, I just wanna put it out. You know, it was just on my heart to do. I was gonna release like a little EP called Freedom Summer, which kind of like it's inspired by last summer, you know, after the Mike Brown situation and all the activism that Black Lives Matter was doing, you know what I'm saying, last summer, and especially what's going on this summer. We dealing with Sandra Bland, we dealing with Christian Taylor, all this other stuff. It's kind of like some music to like, kind of like it's therapy, like the soundtrack to the situation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because like, when you had the civil rights movement, you had civil rights music. You know what I'm saying? You had James Brown, you had Sly Stone or whatever. Not Sly Stone. What am I trying to say? What's his name?
Retro?
No. Sly. What's that? Yeah, Sly Stone, right? Yeah. Whatever. I can't think of his name off the top of my head. This damn Gin, you know what I mean? But anyway, what you had, all I'm trying to say is you had Curtis Mayfield, you had Marvin Gaye, you had artists that spoke.
Yeah, man.
You had artists that spoke to
help you get through the situation.
Help you get through the situation, the soundtrack to it, bro. And like for me, I just try to be the soundtrack. I just try to be the voice for that type of situation. So, and like I said, I put the single out. It did very well. I was gonna do a whole EP, but I'm a teacher. And like during, like so now I literally teach chess for a living. You know what I'm saying? So.
Oh, that's what you do?
That's what I do, yeah. I've been doing youth development work for, in Baton Rouge for 9 years. I started out when I was, you know, in high school in Oklahoma or whatever. So I guess overall I've been doing youth development work since 2002, so 13 years. And like, you know, I got a family and stuff. So during the summertime, school out, you know what I'm saying? I can move. Mm-hmm. School in, my first time, like, you know, as an actual classroom teacher.
So that's what you teach at school?
Mm-hmm. So I teach chess or whatever. But all that to say, like, so I couldn't really do as much. I wanted to do it during the summertime and kind of shut it down and really focus on that and just kind of do a couple shows here. I didn't get the project out in time, so I'm just going to hit and dead it and just work on some other stuff, man. Me and Joe been working on the project for 7 years. That's went through like Google different changes, you know what I'm saying? But it's good though. It's like, it's one of the situations that if you hear the beats, you ain't gonna tell when it was made. Classic, timeless music.
Timeless music.
You know what I'm saying? So, been working on that. We're trying to get that ready or what have you. But, you know, man, just keeping it pushing, bro. Always trying to, like, I got my own lane. I remember when I first started out, like, you know, this is like early 2000s. So this is, you know, Sam I Am, the Jiggalay. That's all it was. Right. You know what I'm saying?
Jig music.
Lyrics
wasn't right. Was a fact.
I mean, I didn't fit in. You know what I'm saying? And I remember trying to like somewhat maneuver that particular lane, right? And it just wasn't me. Like me and Joe made a song called Fat Boy Fresh, and it was cool. It was a cool record. Okay. You know what I'm saying? It was fun. You know what I'm saying? It had some elements of jig to it, but it was a fun song. It was a party song or whatever. But that's not what worked for me though. That's not what people needed from me, whatever. Fast forward, 2 years later, we did a song called Jiggy City Blues. And like originally, we were just talking about this the other day. Originally, let me set it up. So I just got married. I'll take that back. A week before I got married, I got fired from my job. My wife was 6 months pregnant. You know what I'm saying? I'm unemployed, I'm out here hurting. I'm literally at the lowest point in my life. You know what I'm saying? Joe sent me a beat that he actually shot to Trill Entertainment. And the A&R at the time was Big J. Like, I don't know if he passed on it before. I know he's supposed to be shopping it for Boosie. You know what I'm saying? But this might have been right around the time Boosie went to jail. And so he turned it on, I don't remember what the situation was. So he gave it a beat, you know what I'm saying? I wrote to the situation. I started talking, literally, bro. I licked shots at Kip Holden and Sylvia Weatherspoon, The Advocate. You know what I'm saying? I articulated kind of a critical stance of jig music, talking about how, like, you know, this is all what it is, but how come we ain't talking about the other side? And in the last verse, I was literally talking about being unemployed and actually struggling going through the situation. My wife is 8 months pregnant and I'm not working. And she working, you know what I'm saying? And like, all that just kind of, it came together for me. And like, people who knew who I was before, who always told me that kind of shit ain't gonna work, was calling my phone, wanted to work with me this, that, and the third. And luckily, before that, I was on the label for 2 or 3 years, and I was exposed to the industry. So I kind of took what I knew from then and just applied it to then, to what I was doing at the time. And bro, and the Lord blessed me, bro. I just been moving ever since, bro, and I ain't stopped.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of people don't get a chance to spark their career when they 26, 27 years old.
Nah, bro.
But like, I had already been in for a long time.
A lot of your top people in the game in their late 30s.
If you think about it, even Jay, if you think about it, bro, Jay-Z is the same age as Rakim.
Right. Oh, yeah.
But he ain't started till he was 27.
But see, the only
Jay-Z is older than LL, I want to say. Yeah. But LL started when he was 15.
But the only thing about money, you on age. You just, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Jay-Z looked more younger now than he looked when he was young. You see what I'm saying?
He good. He can afford that good diet. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know, but it's a situation to where, like, so basically, bro, nigga just been, and then plus two, bro, before I was married, you know what I'm saying? Still living a college lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Going out partying, drinking, you know, me and my partner was throwing events and stuff like that, just kind of cutting up, right. Had a little part-time job, things of that nature. Wasn't really taking my stuff seriously. So also around that time I got married, got finished with school, you know what I'm saying? Got me a real job, and it's like when I got my life together, that's when everything else aligned with the music. You know what I'm saying? So, and I've been blessed ever since, man. Like, and just keep pushing forward, keep doing the same thing. I realize that people appreciate me more for using my voice to speak on the issues, to speak for, you know what I'm saying, speak for them. It kind of represent, you know what I'm saying, the other side that gets overlooked in Baton Rouge, you know what I'm saying? And that's just kind of been my career way. That's been my lane. And this way, bro, I ain't got no street beef.
Right.
Because I don't have to deal with street niggas in that capacity. Like, of course, you know, I can't necessarily say that's my biggest fan base, but anybody who hear my music, even though it's not what they listen to, they respect it because it's real and it's honest. Like, everybody got a nigga, their cousin that's locked up. Everybody got an auntie that's on dope, but it's that the third. I talk about it, but I talk about it from a systematic standpoint. I talk about, you know, the epidemic of, you know what I'm saying, crack cocaine in the neighborhood. I talk about the private prison complex, you know what I'm saying? And so they can relate to that shit, you know what I'm saying? So so I don't really have to worry about that type of situation. I don't really worry about the radio. They don't play my music anyway, so I ain't trying to beat down Max 94.1 though. Hmm. You know what I'm saying? They don't play my stuff in the club, so I ain't got to worry about that. I can do exactly what I want to do. Ain't nobody in my way. I can move how I want to move, bro, and I be blessed, dog. Like,
you could really trendset that line.
Yeah, man.
For the city, you know?
Bro, I'd put a lot of rappers on.
All right.
Like, I can actually say, like, as far as shows go, bro, in the last 5 years, bro, there's not another person in this city, in this whole area called 225, that has booked more rappers for shows. That, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I done took niggas out of town. I done took niggas as far as Memphis, Jackson. You know what I'm saying? Me and DJ Automatic been all the way to Austin, San Antonio, Houston. You know? I'm Marcel P. Black. This is my mentor, Louisiana hip-hop legend, New Orleans hip-hop legend, Truth Universal. You catch him on truthuniversal.com. He was like the first person to really get me excited about the record One Love. You know what I'm saying? A couple things, True.
Nah, man, it was definitely golden. Like, it's the first time I listened to it. So, that's going far. I mean, they got a remix. That's a powerful song, man. That's like kind of like a paradigm, you know what I'm saying, for like what, you know, quote unquote, conscious hip hop, you know what I'm saying, should be doing. You know what I'm saying? That catches the ears, and it's like, it has a purpose, you know what I'm saying? It catches the ears of different audiences, you know what I'm saying? Like, different pockets of the masses, you know what I'm saying? It's filled with jewels, but it's pleasing, you know what I'm saying, to the ear, you know what I'm saying? And it's definitely, you know, a beautiful product.
So real quick, before the camera, before we go, can I get you to say One Love?
For sure. One Love.
Yeah.
Every city, every block.
Yeah. Marcel P. Black, Truth Universal, we out. Freedom.
But my soul ain't for sale and my spirit ain't for rental. Look, y'all overstand, I need these instrumentals so I can squeeze lead whenever I grip pencils. And I'm aiming at you modern day minstrels, pulling kick doughs on the industry that pimps you. I grew up around neighborhood crips. You know what's in my blood that I bang on the system.
One love.
This is for my people on the corner who get it out the mud from Biara to New Orleans. One love. One love. One love, one love. From every single hood, every block, we coming from the bottom, trying to take it to the top. One love, one love, one love, one love. Yeah, love.
Yeah, it's your boy M Black. Rebellion in the music, I'm about to bring it back. I'm furthering the cause, middle finger to the laws. I'm standing as a man and praying I never fall. I'm about to give you that sociopolitical discourse, but translated a nigga. Playing my position as a voice for the voiceless, with the soundtrack to the struggle that my people survive. I'm just trying to keep my people alive. I'm God body trying to civilize and edify. Neglected by the talented 10th. What happened to the other 90%? I need to know.
I need to know.
If there's a reason, I need to flow. Too many lives cut short when my niggas need to grow. And I will never settle till there's freedom in the ghetto. And we finally cut the screens from Geppetto. I'm beefing with you levels. This is for my people on the corner who get it out the mud from Biara to New Orleans. One love. One love. One love. One love. One love.
senseless gang violence. In the state of Louisiana, we got the number one murder capital, and we number five, man. Let's come together and get this money. That's what hip-hop is supposed to do. It's all one love. My one music. My name is Marshall P. Black. Freedom.
From every single hood, every block, we coming from the bottom, trying to take it to the top. One love. One love. One love. One love. Yeah.
On the cities you hit with the tour, man?
See, the summer I did, okay, let me get it. Memphis, Knoxville, Nashville,
okay.
Birmingham, Mobile, Oklahoma City, Dallas, of course, New Orleans and Baton Rouge. I feel like I'm forgetting something.
Alabama.
Yeah, I think, yeah, that was, cause yeah, so it was 11 cities total and I did New Orleans twice.
Okay.
So that's what it was, yeah, so it was, yeah. Dallas, Oklahoma City, Nashville, Knoxville.
That's your first time touring?
I do. I pretty much every year, man. I started really hitting the road tough 2012. I want to say we did like three shows in Denver. We was in Denver for a week. Me and my boy Alfred Banks out of New Orleans. We was in Denver for a week. Then we did like New Orleans. We did Gulfport. I want to say we did Jackson or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Just, I got a family and stuff, so. Being gone for weeks at a time, I can't necessarily do that. But I might do like six weekends in a row, two dates, whatever, you know what I'm saying? And you know what I'm saying? So just keeping it moving like that, bro. Like, and just San Antonio,
you
hit Austin.
The city early, when you touched on for the show, you hit the city early, beat the street, hit the
got
radio.
To. I mean I like to go there. Check into the hotel, hit the record stores. We always, one thing we did, because me and Alfred, we was running through Tennessee, everywhere we went to, went to the hotel, check into the stores. First thing we do, we trying to find the outlet malls. You know what I'm saying? Try to get our shoe game up. You know what I'm saying? I'm a big dude, so I'm looking for the polo stores with the big tall size. You know what I'm saying? Or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Just trying to get some gear, you know what I'm saying? I collect CDs, like kind of like people collect vinyl. I collect music like that, so I want to find the record stores everybody go to. And then it's also an opportunity to try to network with the record stores, possibly do in stores there, get our product in there. Even if we can't get our product down, consignment or whatever, make sure we get our posters up or whatever. And so now we get the information. When we do drop something, we can just ship it to them or whatever, you know, right. Do the network.
Right.
Sometimes, you know, go to college campuses when we get to the town or wherever we see people at, passing our flyers before the show. That's if we have time to do it, you know what I'm saying? But definitely going to politics, but that's the most beautiful thing about traveling. I'm a big nigga, so I gotta go find whatever rapper bring me there or whatever motive, like, yo, part of my situation is you gotta let me know who got the dopest food.
Right.
So that's why I love going to Jackson, Mississippi. Them niggas have the best food.
Yeah, they got
anywhere you go, I love going to Memphis.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Or whatever. You know, Knoxville had a dope barbecue as well, you know what I'm saying? But you know, just enjoying it, man, like literally, bro, like I can honestly say I went on like 11 or 12 mini vacations or something. Every city I'm kicking it. You know, if it's an early show like we was in Knoxville, after that show was like at 7 o'clock. So afterwards, you know, we gotta drive to Memphis the next day, which is all the way across the state. But hell, we had the show at 9:30. Here to do that. We talked to dude outside. What's the popular clubs out here? Hit the clubs. We're trying to go to the shoe stores, but it was closed already. But hit the clubs up, meet people, passing our flyers, whatever. If we do have promo CDs, pass out the promo CDs, just networking, bro. And just having a good time, you know what I'm saying? Like, so, it's a lot of fun, bro. Like, to me, that's been the best word of mouth, man. If I can go, like, coming from Baton Rouge as an artist, first things first, especially like in the southern states or whatever, like if I'm going to like more of a hood type venue,
right.
They hear Baton Rouge, they think Boosie.
Right.
Everybody love Boosie, right?
Right.
And even though, so they're already on my side just cause of Baton Rouge or whatever. But even though I don't do music like that, it's always a surprise. Like damn, Baton Rouge do got other sides, yeah. Besides this or whatever, right? If I go to a set that's kind of more traditional, underground hip hop or whatever, oh, this nigga come sound like Boosie. And when I don't sound like Boosie, oh shit, Baton Rouge got some real hip hop shit or whatever. So, bro, like that's a way that like, as for a touring artist, it's really been a blessing for me. Because many times I'm the first artist there from Baton Rouge. I guess you can say on the underground level. So, some people, you know, sometimes I'm blessed to have my reputation precedes myself or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And so that works for me. But then it's like the surprise factor of it. Man, I don't know what this big nigga about to come up here and do. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, it didn't, just the best word of mouth. So they hear me about me, they hear me about me in this city. Oh man, that nigga Marcel was dope. I'm bringing to this city, whatever. You know, so it's just been a blessing, bro. I can't complain about it at all. Yeah. I want to say in 5 weeks, I put 6,000 miles on my car, 3 oil changes and 3 tires. Getting to it, bro. Moving. Enjoying every bit of it.
That's what it's about, though, bro. So you say you from Oklahoma, huh?
Mm-hmm.
How you growing up all in the South, man?
Southern. Man, you know what I'm saying? Grew up, raised, all in Oklahoma. Small town, it's 30 miles north of the Texas border, 100 miles north of Dallas, 100 miles south of Oklahoma City, real small town, about 35,000 people. You know what I'm saying? In high school, I was in a band. I played ball when I was a whole lot slimmer.
Right.
About 200 pounds ago, you know what I mean? I played ball or whatever. In my senior year, I kind of had to choose between basketball and band. And realistically, I was recruited by a couple JUCO schools. I could have played somewhere on the bench in Kansas, in all white town in Kansas or whatever. Or I could play the trombone, go to HBCU or whatever. So I kind of chose, you know, music over sports, which is kind of funny because that's where it is right now, you know what I'm saying? So Southern was the first people to get back to me. Originally, my first choice was Tennessee State, but they took forever to get back to me. Southern was the first thing. I came down here. I liked it, came to Southern, and I ended up not being in the band or what have you.
Right.
But loved it down here, been out here ever since. Home now. 13 years, bro.
It's home.
Home.
Right.
Both my babies are born here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Living out here when I got married or what have you.
Okay.
So it's home now.
Right. So what's next for Marcellus P. Black, bro?
Shit, man. Next, my next thing is probably one of the biggest shows I've ever attempted to put on, bro. I'm gonna be at Happy's downtown.
Okay.
136 3rd Street, you know what I'm saying? Gonna be at Happy's.
The Irish bar.
The Irish pub joint. They ain't never had a hip hop show there. ever.
Pull that off, huh? You Marcellus P. Black.
Yeah, bro. You know what I'm saying? A young lady who promotes shows who I worked with before.
Okay.
She reached out to me. It's like, yo, we will try to do this thing. And I ain't gonna lie, it's been hell. Dealing with some politics or whatever.
Like backslash or something.
To be quite frank, bro. At one point, I don't know if you remember, you said you was out of state. At one point, you had two black venues down there. You had the M Bar. And you had the Lyceum, which was black owned. They was always doing parties then. Where the City Bar is right now, it was called the Voyles. And I always had college parties there, right?
The Voyles on the river, huh?
Yeah. But it's you know, it's gone down now as a City Bar. And like, there was, I remember at one point, and I want to say one of the bad business reports, the downtown business reports, it was saying how like, at a certain time, 3rd Street gets kind of dark. So it was kind of a push to get black people off of 3rd Street.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so they're not there no more, right? And a lot of those 3rd Street venues really, really haven't been too kind to like a young black demographic. Like they'll have like blues singers come through, a lot of bands, but like a young urban, as they say, black demographic,
right,
ain't necessarily been too kind to, you know what I'm saying? Right. Been too welcoming,
yeah,
right?
Embracing.
Right, so like when I got this call, I was like, look, bro, it's gonna be a task, I'm gonna do it. It's been hell, but it's gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna happen, I'm gonna make it pop. That's why
she's
I need.
She's a promoter?
Huh?
She a promoter.
Yeah. And so I'm gonna look in the camera and say this. Every person who's ever heard of Marcel P. Black in passing, if you know me personally, I need you at Happy's on September the 12th. Downtown, 136 3rd Street. Hip hop is alive on 3rd Street. It's a free show, and it's my birthday. So you really ain't got no excuse not to be there. Come out. Don't bring the foolishness, because we want to show them that we can come down here and we are a good economic base for them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We will hit the bar.
We're gonna have fun, we're gonna go home.
You know what I'm saying? We gonna be social. We gonna have a good time. You know what I'm saying? We gonna you know what I'm saying? All the artists I got, I didn't want to take no chances on putting no novices on. I got Alfred Banks coming on. Alfred Banks is recently on Revo TV, that's what we was talking about earlier. You know what I'm saying? Like, this dude's official. I got my man Fifth Child is.
Where they from?
He's from New Orleans.
Okay, Alpha Bass from New Orleans.
Yeah, Alpha Bass from New Orleans. My man Fifth Child is from Jackson. He gonna be performing. He, like, this dude has produced music for, like, Mississippi Public Broadcasting. You know what I'm saying? Like, like big type of stuff, you know what I'm saying? I got my man Jason the Hater out of Memphis. This dude's like the OG hip hop in Memphis, you know what I'm saying? I got Go DJ Automatic Spinning. I got my man Donnie Rose hosting the show. I got a special performance by Cafe Ole. It's a dope hip hop funk band out of New Orleans. It's all free, bro. 100% free. You ain't got to pay nothing but for your drinks. That's it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Come through. Ain't no dress code, but you know, we gonna keep it. We gonna keep it classy. We'll have a good time. Keep it safe or what have you. And man, we gonna turn up. You know what I'm saying? It's my birthday too, so I'm definitely gonna be in there. You know what I'm saying? Going in. So, but you're like, that's pretty much my biggest thing that I'm really, really working on, man. I got another event series I'm about to bring back. October 23rd at Chelsea's. It's a Friday night or whatever. Called Rappers Delight, you know what I'm saying? It's the same thing, man. Just bringing dope MCs coming through, rocking, bringing MCs from Houston, bringing MCs from New Orleans, might bring a guy from Memphis in, you know what I'm saying? Doing some dope stuff. I'm working on a event called The Bar Exam or whatever.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I don't have a date for that yet, but I've reached out to a couple venues. Man, just want to do some stuff to where me and Junior was talking about it earlier, man, like Baton Rouge, it got dry. It ain't no open mics popping, ain't no hip hop shows popping, nothing. Like, it don't matter what side of the coin you're on. If you're on the super duper underground, if you're on the jig, bing, bam, it ain't nothing for you right now. It's dry out here, and I'm getting bored, bro. Like, real talk, I sit at home, because I don't go, I'm 31, bro. I go to the club every now and then, but I really, that ain't my thing no more.
Shit, I mean, it's the same thing.
It's the same thing over and over. Like, I like to see live entertainment. Like, in New Orleans, my OG Truth Universal had an event. It was the longest running event in the city of New Orleans called Grassroots New Orleans. And like, bro, when I say he put on so many artists, from 3D Nighty to Currency to D1 to, you know, Alpha Banks, Lyric Hill, Nesby Phipps.
She finna blow up.
What?
3D Nighty?
What? She already signed to All Def Digital. That's Russell Simmons shit.
Oh, bro.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she
is. I just really starting to hear about, maybe.
Nah, bro. Mexico. In my opinion, she the best rapper from New Orleans. Like bar for bar?
Oh, she go.
Bar for bar? Come on, man.
I looked at her one day for a couple of hours.
Man, oh, she a dog, bro. Yeah. She can do anything on the mic, period. Yeah. It don't matter. Content, style.
All out the country.
Right. Yeah. Over in Prague, you know what I mean?
And
she turned down a deal with Timbaland. Because basically they wanted her to be like Nicki Minaj. And she was like, I might be built like that, but I'm here for the bars. I ain't here to be no sex kid.
Yeah.
She was like, I want to go at Jay-Z neck. I want, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so she said it wasn't for her or whatever. And I respect that. Like, as an artist, man, like, you know, people was like, man, she might be crazy for missing those opportunities. But look, if you can't sleep at night, don't.
Don't.
Bro, it's been so many times, like, with my music being a conscious artist, bro, that, like, people would be like, man, you would, I remember when I first started, man, if you weren't doing this conscious shit, I don't want to hear that shit, man. Look, bro, I sleep good, I get paid well, I travel, I have fun, I've been able to meet some of Killer Mike has been always one of my all-time favorite rappers.
Right.
To say that my man is my mentor now through hip-hop,
right.
Through conscious rap.
Right.
I ain't never had to shoot a nigga in no verse, group? I ain't never had to sell no dope in the verse. I ain't got to slap a bitch in the verse, none of that shit.
Right.
Strictly conscious rap, strictly uplifting my people.
Killer Mike and
Run the Jewels.
Run the Jewels,
bro.
Monster,
like,
man.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
Bro.
So it's like, it's monster, like, you know, grew up listening to Nappy Roots, nigga, Slum Village, Mobb Deep, all off of being a conscious rapper. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So I sleep well. I sleep well. I don't never, you know, I feel very, very good. I mean, and it's a blessing to also kind of have a good understanding of the business. So even though I'm not trying to go mainstream, I can tell you what's going on. I can look at a contract and read it to you. I can tell you about how deals break down. I can tell you about 360. I can tell you about the regular contract. I can tell you about publishing. You know what I'm saying? Things of that nature.
You got the knowledge of the game.
Been blessed, bro. I like to read, man. Like, I get the books, like, bro. Since they don't really put them out as frequent now, but I own pretty much every single Source magazine from 2000 to 2014. Like, whenever I move, that's the heaviest shit to carry, right? And bro, I'm looking at, because articles are places where rappers tell the truth. On videos, they lie, interviews, they lie, but like articles or whatever, because you have a journalist kind of chronicling their situation or whatever. So I can tell you when Rick Ross first got hot, type of shit he was saying. I remember when Dipset was just getting hot, because it's all there in print or whatever. I got my degree in history. And so, like, things that I can tangibly see, it kind of record time, I pay attention. So, like, different strategies people use. One great book I read back, The History of the Business of Hip-Hop. And it basically tells you, like, the way certain deals is made, starting in, like, the late 60s all the way up to now. It's a this thing called urban music. I read, you know what I'm saying? I check out all that stuff. All the websites, rapprehab.com. I've been blessed to have OGs like Truth Universal, you know, Kamikaze. I was part of Crooked Letters with David Banner. People who I talk to on the daily when I seek, you know, if I need some advice, I seek them out. You know what I'm saying? I got homeboys like Tel Poe is my guy. You know what I'm saying? One of the main MCs and activists, part of the Black Lives Matter movement. You know, this guy, you know, came back, you know, he was in Palestine, in Geneva.
Right.
Also plenty of other shit, you know what I'm saying? So like, you know, been blessed to have people who, you know, have really made some big accomplishments and strides in the industry that I can call my friends and mentors and peers. And if I need some game from them or whatever, if I can swap something out, it's certain people, it ain't that many people, Joe's one of them. But it ain't too many people who can call my phone and any resource I have, I give it to them. Huh. Right? You know what I'm saying? And it's like certain people who I respect that much, I can help a lot for shit. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of the time, I try to give as much advice as I can, but I don't have time for everything.
Yeah.
A lot of people just want to get put on and they're going to get hooked up.
Yeah.
If I got a plug, I either grinded my ass 10 years for it to get it for myself, or somebody who's been grinding longer than me feels like I've earned the right for them to give it to me.
Right.
So a nigga just come off the street, I can't necessarily do that.
Shit.
I can tell you how to work to get it, but a lot of niggas don't want to work to get shit. They want me to be like, yeah, man, I'll book you for this 10 city tour. Nah, player.
Don't work like that.
No, sir. That's time and money I'm investing in myself. I'm taking away from my kids and my family. I'm telling my wife, little baby, this is what it's going to be, this, that, and the third. I just can't just, it's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears that go into that. I just can't just come off of that easy, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, but it's all been a big process though, bro. And I love it. I love the hustle. I'm one of the rappers that I'll jump and tell you, I like to work, my nigga.
Yeah.
Like, I like that shit. The shit the niggas don't want to do, nigga just want to release some shit, put it online,
right,
and spend $100 on a video. And
think it's gonna happen.
And think, nigga, that's the end all be all.
Yeah, it don't work like that.
Nigga, I like to go out with flies in my hands and CDs in my hands and get to it. I like to go to different cities. I like to do that
I'm
shit.
I'm a hustler, dog. Like, you know what I'm saying? We're running with live for you, dog. And I ain't worked in over a decade.
Mm.
I'm just a hustler.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I was talking to another hustler in the game. Man, I do 5 or 6 different hustles.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing about the internet, bro, it's good, it's a gift and it's a curse.
Right, I agree.
But some niggas feel like, I post this picture, you don't need to go out there and do the legwork, but you ain't touching the people. It take the hustle off some niggas. Some niggas know what it's for.
Right.
And it add to the hustle, but some niggas feel like, oh, I didn't post this picture. I had one nigga talking about, I said, dog, you don't put the promotion, you know, part of the thing, you don't go around past. Oh man, I just posted it on Instagram. Oh yeah, nigga.
That's it?
Yeah, like, so everybody on your page, nigga?
I mean, bro, I'm gonna tell you this. Like, two things I wanna say. First and foremost, like, I'm 31, so I'm blessed. I remember I was the first nigga in my high school to have a cell phone, right? I'm blessed to come up in an era, like probably one of the last eras to where we didn't have necessarily social media technology on our side. So I remember, like, my dad's a gospel singer. So I remember, like, my daddy was a gospel singer, so he had a studio in his den. My dad produced, I don't know how many albums in his den that just sound professionals, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Just him saying, he sing, play drums, keyboards, play guitar, all that. Anyway, so I've been blessed to have some of the musical genes, couldn't necessarily sing that well, so, you know, I picked up the mic. All that to say, me and my partner was doing music at my father's den. It took us all the time to do it, like I said. Took us a whole summer to do 3 or 4 songs. It take 15 minutes to actually get these CDs, get this music from tape onto CD. We got an old school CD burner. It takes 15 minutes times 50, however many time it is, to get all 50 of them done, you know what I'm saying? Back then, you know, growing up in Smallton, Oklahoma, dog, we didn't have a hip-hop radio station.
Yeah.
So if we wanted to take our stuff to the black radio station, we had to drive 100 miles north to Oklahoma City, 100 miles south of Dallas. They ain't never played our shit, but it was just part of the hustle, though. And we wanted people to hear our stuff, man, it wasn't no MySpace, it wasn't no social media, it wasn't no SoundCloud, nothing like that or whatever. We couldn't get our shit on Napster or nothing like that, you feel me? So it was putting CDs in our books at going to school, you know what I'm saying, with our own hand-drawn artwork, trying to slam them with $5 or whatever somebody paid for them, give them free, going to the barbershops, went to the community center. Nigga would start our own ciphers in front of the community center.
Right.
But you know, people in the crew, where the people come in, and when we finish, hey man, check our stuff out.
Right.
And this is what I was doing when I was 16, 17 years old.
Right.
You feel me? So I was blessed to understand that people are your best currency, right? So like, I don't depend on radio stations or DJs or whatever to pay me, right? People are my best currency, right? And me building a particular relationship with a person, you know what I'm saying? And you know, be it a friend, be it a family member, you know, making them fans of what I'm trying to accomplish or whatever. Like that's been my biggest selling point, what have you. Fast forward, I'm blessed to be young enough to understand how the internet works too. So I'm coming into my, you know, early to mid 20s when social media is coming in, like as far as stuff, the different tools that it is for artists. So I see a lot of cats who can't tell you what life was like with only 56K. Who can't tell you what it was like to have dial-up internet. Like back then, I couldn't email a song to a DJ. It wasn't no MP, you couldn't send no CD, you know what I'm saying? You couldn't do that back then. There wasn't no link you could download, whatever. I had to literally drive 100 miles to do this shit. And never got my shit played, right? And so, now kids now, you know what I'm saying? You can be on the same computer. You can record a whole mixtape. You can get your little bullshit mix on it. You create your graphics. You can put it on social media, that people, the same computer. One computer. Nigga, I ain't
email to all of
these. And whatever you want to do. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, back then, nigga, I ain't start recording on the computer until I was damn near 20. I'm talking about straight. I can't mix shit on Pro Tools, but give me a goddamn analog set.
Right.
It's up there.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like that, 'cause that's how I learned. That's what I had to go through, whatever. And I think that's the difference, man. And I think it's kind of made me a mentor in the community. I'm only 31, but they look at me like the OG because I've done both. And it's tangible experience that I've had doing the shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's like I can tell you different strategies. And a lot of some niggas do. Now my nigga Alpha Banks, he's 24 years old, bro. By the time he's 27, we gonna be talking about him as like he done been in the 10 years. And he was trained by OGs on days when he off of work. This nigga would set up a merch table on Canal Street and just sell this shit. He might make $100 a day. You know what I'm saying? Which might be not that much considering you out there for 3 hours, but he could have been at home.
Yeah.
Or you could
work an 8-hour shift on right. Sale, get here, you gonna come home with $60.
Right. You know what I'm saying? And it's like it's a situation, bro. It's like I've sold damn near 3,000 CDs of trap hop hand to hand out my trunk. Never put it in the store. I ain't never mailed a copy. Nigga just bought this shit either at a show or when he see me in the street. Right.
Right.
All together with my A projects, I probably sold. And Joe slapped me if I'm lying, bro. I could probably say I've sold close to about 7,000, 8,000. Joe to press up a lot of, that's how I'm asking him or whatever.
Right.
He pressed up, but like all the projects together, whatever, that's just nigga, like at minimum go by 5. Do the math. That's some bread, you know what I'm saying? That's some bread, right?
I do a number, that's what I fuck with.
Independently, no label, no artist or whatever. And now, if you ask me how many I sold on Bandcamp of Trap Hop, maybe 300. Times 3,000, because that's just people. I invest in people. Like, because I tell a different story. I try to make music that people actually buy. Because if you think about a nigga making a club song, can't none of us in this room say the last time they went to a club and be like, hey, I'm going to go buy this shit right now.
Right.
Or a song that's on the radio, hey, I'm going to buy this shit right now.
For the moment.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because that's what it's for, whatever. Like, the albums that, I mean, we came up in the era to where the shit was real. We had that shit every single day. Not just randomly when we go out or whatever, like some shit that kind of speak to our souls or whatever, right? And so I try to provide that experience, the exact same thing, bro. I try to tell our stories, because not everybody does this, not everybody does that or whatever. But it's certain things that affect us all. Even if you're not a conscious nigga, the struggle still affects you. If you're a black man in America, if you're a black woman in America, if you're poor in America, if you're a person of color in America, the struggle will hit you. There's a system out here designed to take us out. You feel me? Regardless of what you do, nigga, if you're a garbage man, if you're a D-boy, or if you're a preacher, you can get it too. Like, that shit don't discriminate, you know what I'm saying?
You can do my last words on my lips, I am
automatic on the track.
A revolutionary. And you're gonna have to keep on saying that. You're gonna have to say that I am a proletarian.
Hey yo, my mama named me Marcel, my favorite color's black. The peak is for the people from the corner to the sea.
Uh-huh.
Cause they beefing with the evil, so I keep a desert eagle.
Uh-huh.
Heard of that Jim Crow and all the Uncle Sam's kinfolk.
Right.
I'm so black, it'll make a cracker hate me.
Woo.
The flow was so crack, you can blame Ronald Reagan. 1983, the day was born. doing knowledge. Man. The block was my tutor, I maneuver through maneuver.
Oh Lord!
I keep it underground like a sewer, trying to take it to the top for the lows in the chicken house. In the city that I'm from, trying to put it on the map. Five, I'm about to eight, get attacked, oh, put the city on my back. From Ardmore to Oakland, shit the circuit bound up the stadium crowd.
Stadium status.
I would never back down, never. Call me Marcel Pete Brown, cause I'm black and I'm proud. Wow. Hey yo, my middle name is Marcel, my fist stays black,
black.
For power over devils I devour, uh-huh. Over prayers every hour makes a lot like I'm Islamic. I'm piling with the guys while you still stutter rebonic. Ejected by officials cause I'm flagrant with these phonics. I rep for the neglected so they label me a problem.
Cause
they don't wanna see the rise of a black messiah. Go and tell pro probably monitor my flows. They overstand I am way more dangerous, uh-huh, with freedom in my speech than I am with the beat. Freedom is something I believe you gotta fight for, so you rarely hear me ever say peace. From Baton Rouge to Jerusalem, any MC said they want it, bet I'm bruising them. I'ma always stay down. M-Rap Brown, I'm black and I'm proud. Wow, wow. People call me Marcel, my clothes stay black.
All
the
black.
Beat is for profit, I be clicking like a rocket. See, I'm trying to make a profit with the message that is proper. And I will never stop it, you can catch me diddy popping. Middle fingers through the coppers, my simile's a chopper. My tongue is a bullet, devils die when I pull it. I'm rapping revolution to the fullest. And this is more than rhetoric, this is rebel music.
Rebel music.
Trap mindset over boom, bad beats, RPG coming straight from the streets. Black belt in their hard body karate.
A
biggie looking nigga in that jigger, they say I'm retarded. From crack houses to campuses, stay reppin' melanin anywhere I'm nippin' in. I keep a rushing, you will never not be down. Marcel Brown, I'm black and I'm proud. Bow, bow, bow.
Yeah, we back, you hear me? Just checked out my people, Marcellus P. Black Lives video.
When you dropped that video, man?
Oh, man, it's been a while that one came out.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm slipping, I ain't gonna lie, bro. That's one thing I ain't been on.
Right.
Cause I be so focused on what can I invest to get me money right back or whatever. And one, that's one thing I have been slipping on that I need to slap myself back ahead on, bro. I ain't had a video for like the last couple projects.
Okay.
My tour's been up, my sales been up, my show's been up.
So you're doing something, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right, right. But it's something I need to do. Ain't an excuse for it or whatever.
Right.
So what you looking at, shit, I probably did that like 2012, bro.
Right.
But I promise you, you know what I'm saying, whatever me and Joe come out, we're gonna have a couple of them things, you know what I'm saying, a couple of new joints or whatever.
Oh, good.
You know what I'm saying?
For the artists, like, you know, in Baton Rouge, you know, like you said, for the most part, it was jig music. Boosie had his line with the gangster music. Gates came with the lyrical. Your lane.
Mm-hmm.
Break down for us, you know what I'm saying? Like the lane you traveling, what it means to be in your, you know what I'm saying?
Nah. All right, so I consider myself, first of all, I'm a fan of hip hop. Like, so it's a misconception that because of the type of music I do, that I don't listen to nothing else but that, right? Like, straight up, I'm bumping Scottie Kane nonstop. That's a lane. You know what I'm saying? Like I like what he do. You know what I'm saying?
He got a mad flow.
You know what I'm saying? When he say, I die behind my daughter, put that on my daughter. Guns kill people. People with daughters be cautious. As a man with a daughter, I feel that shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But you know, so I grew up listening to pretty much everything. You know what I'm saying? But for me, what really stuck with me, man, was like the conscious shit. Like I remember, like, you know, I come from a place, dog, that like, it's one of the places that crack hit real hard. You know what I'm saying? You know, like, kind of like, you know, Ice Cube's how I spent my summer vacation or whatever. And he was talking about like going to these different spots in the South and the Midwest and setting up shop out there. That's how my hometown was sit. So like niggas where I'm from been like gangbangers since like the late 80s, like hard. Like they call my place Little Compton. You know what I'm saying? Like nigga, 90s, 60s, 20s, you know what I'm saying? 5 Deuce Hoovers, 10-7 Hoovers, 4-5-6 Pyrus, Treetops. They got some GDs out there. Like niggas, it's a small town, ain't but like 35,000 people, maybe 3,000 black people, but niggas bang.
Yeah, Oklahoma bang.
You know what I'm saying? So like,
a lot of niggas don't know that.
Right.
So people always think Cali, but you got it.
Well, because this is where they, all the niggas, some niggas who got ran out of Cali, and you got the cats who just, you know, they enterprising.
Right.
You find a quiet town to tie it down, you know what I'm saying? So, like, they had a big influence on me. Like, the music, so I could really relate to that West Coast gangbanger music, and then, like, that was part of our culture. Mm-hmm. Niggas wore rags on whatever side. You gonna play to Oklahoma City right now, nigga got the Selly Cell brains, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So like right now, like in Oklahoma City, whatever. So they had a big influence on me, you know what I'm saying? So coming up in that, there's some things I wasn't proud of. There's some things, some people I probably shouldn't have been with or whatever. And I was it was getting kind of fuzzy. You know, when you're about 10th grade, you start bucking your mom, bucking with your daddy, whatever. I was at this stage. My first cousin, he's 4 years older, he's a 5%er. And it was a freshman in college, and he came back with that guy body knowledge or whatever. So he came back, and he put me up on like, I always loved hip hop, whatever, but I heard it, I never really listened to it. It really, like, you know, I like the punchlines and the metaphors, or if they said some fly shit, but like in terms of like the actual deeper meaning, and like using, like kind of take advantage of the educational aspects of it, right? Like I first heard about Ivan Van Sertima listening to Nas, you know what I'm saying? So all that to say, he brought me back like brand new being, put me up on the roots, you know what I'm saying? Made sure I had that most kept back on both sides on deck. You know what I'm saying? Dead Prez, bro, he brought me back a Dead Prez album, Let's Get Free. That's where the shirt come from, Can't Sell Dope Forever. That's one of the albums they put out. But they had a song on the album, Let's Get Free, called They Schools, right? Now mind you, I'm listening to whatever's on the radio. They grew up listening to Crippin' Blood tapes, all that gangsta shit, right? The hardest first hook I ever heard, Dead Prez, like, they schools don't teach us shit. We try to get freedom, we need to get all we can get. So all my high school teachers can suck my dick telling me white men's lies, straight bullshit. That was the hardest shit I ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
Like, it was since I was like, oh, nigga, what the fuck? Now I done listened to rappers, I done heard niggas talk about killing niggas every which way.
Right?
That was the hardest shit I ever heard. All right, did this nigga just really just say that? You know what I'm saying? And so like, it just kind of opened up. It's just like my mind just kind of opened up or whatever. And so I came back, it was Christmas break. I came back, listened to the shit, told my cousin, like, say cuz, like, bro, like, what is this? I need some more of this shit. He was like, all right, I'm gonna give you some more music, but I'm gonna give it to you if you promise me you read these books too.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm listening to the music, you know what I'm saying? The underground shit, the conscious shit, the thought-provoking shit, your ex-clans, your poor righteous teachers, like I said, your brand new beings, the Raz Cavs, you know what I'm saying? When he dropped Nature of the Threat, like, that shit was like a book, you know what I'm saying? Listening to it, you know what I'm saying? And reading the books, kind of getting knowledge or whatever. And at the same time, I'm still where I'm at. So I still gotta survive. I still gotta go to school without playing ball and, you know what I'm saying, kicking with niggas and my kinfolk. Now my little nephew, you know what I'm saying, he just caught a RICO charge. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Because the people he run with. Mm. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I'm probably supposed to be from neighborhood Crip because my god brother is. He OG, right? I was blessed to have parents and to have a community that supported me doing other. You know what I'm saying? So, and then my father's he's a juvenile probation officer, a juvenile justice officer rather. And he was that dude, you came to him, he was on your caseload, he tried every single thing he could to get you off.
Right.
He didn't want Joshua. You right. Know what I'm saying?
That's the ladder result.
Yeah, right. He was like, look, bro, I want you to do everything you can, I'm gonna work with you. So all that to say, the street aspect, the gang aspect, and then at the same time, the academic, the knowledgeable, you know what I'm saying, the conscious shit all meshed together. You know what I'm saying? And so like, I consider my like I've heard when I did A3C 2 years ago, people from A3C, what they say my music is a mixture of gangster rap meets Malcolm X meets a Baptist preacher. So it's still street, but it's all conscious or whatever. And I like to consider myself a non-traditional conscious rapper, because a lot of times people think conscious rap, and please believe it ain't no shade to conscious, whatever, traditional conscious rap, because I definitely have records like that, I like it, and I still make it. But like, I like to take the type of songs that people listen to, that people feel to, the stuff I like to listen to, and just put my conscious music on top of it. I don't limit myself to old soul samples and lo-fi drums and shit like that or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, 2 years ago, my biggest project to date, Trap Hop, True Rebellion Against Poison, Harm and Oppressed People. I picked 7 trap beats and just rap straight conscious shit over. Right. You know what I'm saying? And like, I'm literally like telling niggas, say, bro, go to school, get your mind right. These white folks trying to get us out here. You know what I'm saying? It's very preachy, but it opened up my lane. It took me out of just the boom, bap, yo, hip hop shit, which I love to death, where I come from. But it put me like, you know, young niggas on the streets is fucking with it. Like, the industry shit really started fucking with it. This is when the Run of Jewels show, and then in A3C festival, and all the other shit started calling. Shit, white folks, like the college citizens and shit like that or whatever, that shit really opened my fan base, because it gave them something that you can think to and dance to. So like, the chant is, these boys ain't trapping right, these boys is trap. And you say the repetition, and the beat banging, next thing you know, you were saying some conscious shit, don't even realize it.
Right.
But you feel the shit or whatever, right? And so, man, that was probably like the biggest project of my career. And it really, really opened me to every single thing. To right at this point, bro, I can make whatever type of song I want to, because my fans understand like the scope of my art. I'm not limited to no type of song. At first it was like, oh, you can only do this one type of music, one style or whatever.
Edge in the box.
And I say, fuck that, because people are different.
Yeah.
Like, I'm up here saying this shit, I just killed a cup of gin, you know, gin and juice or whatever. Like, I'm a regular everyday person. Like, if you think about it, I want to say, like, people talk about mainstream rap, but I want to say, like, it might have been Stickman from Dead Prez. He was like, we talk about mainstream. The average mainstream person, just like the average everyday person, is not living like Rick Ross. They're not living like Wayne. The average nigga is just, you know what I'm saying, they about a check and a half away from living check to check. Working, taking care of their family, they want to have some fun every now and then, they want to get fresh every now and then, they're still dealing with the struggle, but they're just trying to survive every single day. And like, and they're not one dimensional.
Yo, yo, so it be like, Marcel, we know you on that black stuff. But sometimes a nigga just wanna hear you spit.
That's real, I got you.
It's the return of that hard body. Black space, God body. Ether in your speakers, catch me mobbing like I'm John Gotti. Hard mode nigga, but I'm living in that jigger with them hustlers stacking figures and them killers pulling triggers.
Oh, no.
I've been repping like Bin Laden with big weapons. G-high flow, the patois is far too wide. Holy war, and I'm beefing with your devils. Got the blood of a runaway, soul of a rebel. Without a pause, no regard for the laws, cause I'm rolling with my loaf and I'm banging with my dogs.
With my dog.
Post in front the corner store and block music. That's all the slim that B.I.G. Pimp C and Pop Prison. This here is the antithesis of pop music. No, I ain't hating on you. Gon' get your paper, homie. Just know that that fat rapper from Oklahoma is bringing raw back in 011. I'm taking over. Shake 'em. I no longer have some, but the flow is still going so dumb. The delivery's retarded, the energy is pow, 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 pow. But you get me started. They say the Lord's hard, use the toast was as a modern day disciple. I'm strapped with a rifle, Biggie's album in the Bible in the back of my knapsack. I'm banking RBG, don't confuse it with backpack, cause it's still so true. Lyrically, I still be nobody but me. Yeah, I like black dog.
We back, man. Got my people, man. We done wrapped up another good segment. A lot of good information that came out, you know what I'm saying? Got my people in here. One of the most influential people on the market right now in Baton Rouge for a part of promotion, trend setting, new music, putting artists on, bringing artists here. You know, just touched a lot of topics, man. Fighting this, trying to get a movement downtown Baton Rouge, you know what I'm saying? For our people.
Like, yeah, man.
Hip hop's still alive. We should be allowed to go everywhere. We know how to conduct ourselves, man. So, you know, it's all about just positive vibes, making good music.
Indeed, bro.
Taking care of these families, man.
Got to, bro.
Yeah, man. So what you, let them know again what you got going on the 12th, bro.
September 12th, yeah. Habby's Downtown, 136 3rd Street, Baton Rouge Hip Hop Project. That's my organization, you know what I'm saying? We got writers, we got bloggers, we got DJs, we got MCs, we got people with radio shows, man. We try to really put on for the city. Bring just some dope. We're trying to bring diverse people from diverse backgrounds. We all come together September the 12th, Happy's Downtown, 9 o'clock. You know what I'm saying? Free show. Myself, Alfred Branks, Fifth Child, Jason the Hater, Cafe Ole, or how do you say it? I'm sorry. Hosted by Donnie Rose, Go DJ Automatic on the ones and twos. We have a great time, bro. Then, like I said, next October 23rd at Chelsea's Cafe. You know what I'm saying? Bring it back, Rappers Delight. Just some dope hip hop, you know, it's kind of been a drought, been a little dry in Baton Rouge. Dope hip hop, dope MCs, a good time. Like, if anybody's been to my events, man, we run a tight ship. It ain't that you come down, you wait all night, and the mics is bad. Nah, we like, I pride myself in the Baton Rouge Hip Hop Project. We pride ourselves on being professionals and giving you the highest quality event to where you come through. And like, you know what I'm saying? Dope hip hop, but you have fun too. Like I said, come. The 12th, you ain't got to pay no money at the door. Just come in and party, get your drink on. We're going all the way up, bro. Cutting up that night. Straight up, bro. Hip hop is alive on 3rd Street.
Support my man, man. This groundbreaking. We need this, you know what I'm saying? Like people say, you had the M-Boy, you had the Lice, you had, you know, they had their thing on, we had our thing on. We need to bring that back, man. We need that, you know
right.
what I'm saying? We shouldn't just be stuck to one side of town, you know what I'm saying?
So, right.
Let's get out there and support my people, man. It was a pleasure, bro.
Pleasure's always, brother, man. Congratulations, man. This store, man, I love what you're doing here.
Appreciate
love
it,
love to see a black man with, you know what I'm saying, business giving a space to other people trying to do something positive. It's always a beautiful thing, man. Much congrats to you.
Man, appreciate it, man. Check out my people, man. Let them know about your Instagram, your YouTube, where they can find your material, man.
Already, bro. Main place you can find me, MarcelPBlack.com. Just put MarcelPBlack.com. You can find everything there. MarcelPBlack, what have you, .com. Instagram, Marcel P. Black. Facebook, Marcel P. Black. Twitter, Marcel P. Black. YouTube, Marcel P. Black. You can, if you want to catch any of my music, you can go to marcelpblack.bandcamp.com. 7 out of my 8 projects, you can download, and you can download for free or what have you. If you want to order a physical copy, you can order a physical copy of my latest album, Black Collar, on my Bandcamp or my website. You know what I'm saying? All the information is there. You know what I mean? Been blessed, bro. Baton Rouge Underground King, believe that.
Live with Swayze, The Antidote, Real Prophet TV. You know how it's going down. Images of Powerball, 341 Plank Road, Sweet B, fuck with me.
Ala Mahabi, free.
That's me. I bet you hear me around the corner when I'm coming. Yeah. You're... I like my city loud. I pull up like pow. I like my shit loud. I don't really turn it down, cause I like my shit loud. Get the fucking lot of clown out. I like my shit loud. I like my shit loud. Yeah, I like my shit loud. Bow, bow, bow. I like my shit loud. Bow, bow, bow. I like my shit loud. Who's that? They're making all that noise. Riding around the city tripping with all them boys. Who's that? They're making all that noise. Riding around the city strapped with all them boys. Smelling like weed and talking to them girls. Honking on that horn and waking up the world. I got a call from the tree man. He said I got some dodo. I said shit, bring it through cause we gon' need some mojo. Better yet, I see you. Just give me like a few to stop at the gas station.
dice and get a fifth and some juice. And 6x9 say the truth to run the cat up off your patio. It's factual. The pressure got him punching just like Accio. Hit me around the corner. You can hear me in front of the crib. Knocking pictures off the wall up out the window. Feeling weird. Diamonds clear up in my ear. You can see him when I steer the steering wheel. Brushing off my gear. Plus my gears. Yeah. Turning up my pioneers. I like my shit loud. Phone wrong, but I can hear it. I pull up like pow. I like my shit loud. I don't really turn it down. Cause I like my shit loud. Hit the fucking lot and clown out. I like my shit loud. I like my shit loud. Yeah, I like my shit loud. Bow, bow, bow. I like my shit loud. Bow, bow, bow. I like my shit loud. Who's that girl making all that noise? Riding around the city tripping with all them boys. I got that pow. Loud beating in the trunk, run up on me, blow, pow, pow, bleed him with a pump. I'm young, duh, duh, dumb, you can spy me from a mile. I'm loud, fast ass a block party, buck up in the crowd. I make the bitches proud when they hear that pound pressure. All that ass start to shaking, girl, don't let my round pressure. And bring it to my click house, that's where you gon' get flipped out. But we just walk up in the room and pull a dick out. Okay, they got to keep it gutter as I run it like a relay. That radio, my DJ, put that gangster shit on replay. Switching lane to lanes, keep that flame of best believe. You and my little thing, bitches claiming like they need me. You know how I be acting in my Cadillac. I'm swagging with them amplifiers slapping. Better than Michael Jackson. My music draw attention, I'm a number one attraction. I bet the police acting, turn it down when they passing. I pull up like pow, I like my shit loud. I don't really turn it down, cause I like my shit loud. It's a fucking lot of clown out, I like my shit loud. I like my shit loud, yeah, I like my shit loud. Bow, 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 I like my shit loud, bow. Making all that noise. Riding around the city tripping with all them boys. As I pull up like bow, I like my shit loud. They like type that shit down. Knock a snipe your chick now. Have her on back of them letters. See your wife can't sit down. She cutting up like she probably about to wipe that dick down. Pop, pop that pussy for a poke chop. Do it big. Ride bounce to the music, girl, gon' jig. The way you rockin', you's a true Louisiana animal. You fuck around and then you gon' make me handle you. Ride around, swerving, tipping, dipping through the city. My sound system beating, shaking, weaving, make it dizzy. Dizzy, going AWOL, all at the shell stole out. Wildin' out, now that's the shit we go to jail for. With a pistol and some dope, no. Look, that's a hell no. Got to be on your shit when you got that off the cell. Don't be cut up bad, get it pop and hear the echo. My song knock around the ghetto, let me in, my shit say hello. I pull up like pow, I like my shit loud. I don't really turn it down, cause I like my shit loud. Hit the fucking lot and clown out, I like my shit loud. I like my shit loud, yeah, I like my shit loud. Bow, 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 I like my shit loud, bow.